Okay, let's go back to the let's go back to the Ben Shapiro point of view on reacting to the Meghan and Harry's Whine-Fest. I already talked about this. I'm sure there will be a video of my perspective tomorrow or today on my YouTube. Let me see. Let me hit up my hold on.
Poggies.
All right, let's keep going.
Let's actually get to what Meghan Markle and Prince Harry actually said. Because, I mean, what difficult lives they lead. It is one of the saddest stories I've ever heard. I mean, a prince grew up a prince, was shielded from his own idiocy for literally years. Remember, Prince Harry was a guy who just back in 2005 dressed up in like a full-on Nazi uniform at a Halloween party. Right, so like Ralph Northam would just never happened, right? It's pretty incredible how that guy is now Captain Woke. So that's exciting stuff. Repentance is possible, people. All you have to do is take your entire family and just toss them under the bus. And meanwhile, Meghan, what a victim. What a difficult life she has led. I can't speak enough about what a heroine she is.
I'm really confused by this because is he doing cancel culture on a guy who is simply expressing their freedom of speech? Like, very, very shocking to see Ben Shapiro get upset. I guess he prefers when people don't wear the Nazi outfits because then it's hypocritical of him to defend them. Maybe that's the reason. Like, he's like, hey, guys, why are you giving the game away? I mean, obviously, if you don't wear the Nazi outfit, I can defend you if you say Nazi things. But if you wear the Nazi outfit, then, well, it's... Even my dumbass conservative fans are going to recognize that you might be, you know, Nazi adjacent.
And just the amount of heroism that she displayed by going on Oprah and ripping on her in-laws' family for fame and fortune. I mean, truly incredible stuff. It's tough. It's tough. I mean, so many tough things have happened to Meghan Markle. Like one time Kate Middleton taught her to curtsy. Or Prince Harry taught her to curtsy right before she met the queen. You know, it's just because she was an ignorant American, you see. And then she was ushered into the halls. But then she saw the flaws in the royal family in a way no one else could because she'd experienced American-style racism. So she was shocked to see it in the halls of royalty. That's it. By the way, Netflix movie coming out in a year. Watch. Starring them, probably. Right? Well, maybe, I don't know. Maybe she'll recast herself, but I don't know. Maybe she likes seeing herself on film. Who the hell knows? In any case, here she was explaining, you know, the Prince Harry taught her to curtsy. She was just a little down-home girl from America, and she came in, and she had to learn the ways of the royals, but only she.
I like that Ben is masking the experience that Meghan Markle had, which, by the way, at the same time, like, come on, yes, she's a fucking princess. Like, ultimately, it's literally winning the lottery, okay? You won an incredible spawn point if you are a royal family person, okay? You know, there's obviously some setbacks. There are some self-inflicted nerfs, like Habsburg jaw, other like genetic problems that come along with centuries of inbreeding, but pretty significant socioeconomic upper hand that is unimaginable to many parts of the other world. You know what I mean? Like, as far as like your spawn point goes, like you got the best one. And same for Meghan Markle, like you're very attractive. You end up fucking marrying a royal. You've married into the royal family. So like, yeah, it's you're super, super lucky.
Thanks,
right?
All the entertainment.
But that doesn't change the reality that like all of those other incredibly lucky people are just like being racist to her. You know what I mean? Like that's not. Oh, sorry. You married into the royal family, so yeah, suck it up. You're gonna fucking experience racism. Like, it is a very weird position for Ben to take, because he's technically, supposedly, you know, the debate lord guy for the conservatives who like to portray themselves as, you know, common folk, those who understand the plight of the average American and care about the average American. So I find it very odd that Ben Shapiro, as an American conservative, is going to engage in a defense of British royalty here and the royal family and monarchy, which is illiberal. It is the most illiberal thing you can do.
HasanAbi, did you see that NBA player Myers Leonard had a game a moment earlier?
Okay. It is the most illiberal thing that you can do is defend the royal family. But he's only doing it because it owns the libs. This goes back to, I have no personal politics. I just want to own the libs, which is ironically how you can categorize all reactionary politics. It is a reaction to progress and change. So that's what Ben is doing again, engaging in reactionary politics by not maintaining a consistent position on like royalty, monarchy, royal family, any of that sort of shit, and simply owning the libs. And anyone who owns is a lib, obviously, including the fucking prince, who is a lib, and Meghan Markle, who is a double lib because she was an actress in Hollywood. So that's one check mark for being a liberal, and black, half black, but still one check mark for being a liberal, obviously.
He was able to identify their deepest secret flaw.
Okay, I'm not watching this. No, I can't do it. That was... That was very strange. It's gonna be... I'm just gonna power through the cringe, okay? This is what no pussy does to a motherfucker. Like, literally, though. Like, this is... You want to know what no pussy does to a motherfucker? It's this. Like, people meme about it, but it is genuinely a problem. Okay? Catboy Shabibo.
Sism. Here we go. With Oprah.
Harry and I are in the car, and he says, okay, well, my grandmother's there, so you're going to meet her. I thought, oh, great. I love grandma. I loved my grandmother. I used to take care of my grandma. This is great. He goes, right, do you know how to curtsy? What? He said, do you know how to curtsy? Now, I thought genuinely that that was what happens outside.
Yeah.
I thought that was part of the fanfare. Or,
uh-huh.
I didn't think
that. Okay, this shit's like whatever, though. This isn't even like, this isn't the main point of view. I'm sure Ben is going to get to the racism in a second.
That's what happens.
Yeah, who gives a fuck? Yeah, they're old people. They got like very weird random customs. Who gives a shit?
Side. And yeah. I said, but it's your grandmother. He goes, it's the queen.
Wow.
And that was really the first moment that the penny dropped.
Oh my God. She never realized she was supposed to curtsy before the queen. So that's, well, what a difficult, I mean, how difficult must that have been to have to curtsy before the queen of
Okay, no one gives a shit about this, right? I mean, this is precisely why I didn't talk about these this part of the conversation at all, because this is, like, completely irrelevant. Like, using this, Ben Shapiro's talking about this and shitting on it because, like, who cares? Yeah, you fucking curtsy for the queen. It's just, it's shocking, but that's the entire purpose of this, like, interview is, like, showing you an insider look, right? Into the royal family, who gives a shit? But ultimately, this isn't the bread and butter or the meat of the interview. The interview's meat is the racist shit that was going on behind scenes. And the reason why Ben is like beefing up the argument here with this frivolous, ridiculous bullshit is so that he can make it seem like the things that she is complaining about are bullshit and they're ridiculous. And therefore, the racist stuff is also ridiculous. Like, come on, she's like complaining about curtsying.
Of England? My God, how humiliating. You know, like every other human who curtsies before the Queen of England or bows before the Queen of England? Can't believe it. Just crazy. Crazy, crazy stuff. And that's when the penny dropped and she was about to learn of the predations of the royals. And what, by the way, it's not all on Meghan Markle. Harry's the actual villain of this piece. Okay, Harry grew up with these people and now he's just dumping all over his entire family. Harry is a bag of garbage. Harry is terrible. Harry was Captain, I'm going to dress up however I want to dress up. I'm going to go to Las Vegas and get naked and smoke pot on the basis of my royal heritage. And then he's like, and you know what I'm going to do now? I'm going to take my entire family. I'm just
Dude, he's such a nerd, dude. He's such like a villainous, annoying, petty, jealous nerd. How the fuck do people watch this guy and go, man, this is content, brother. I love this shit. Like, if you literally enjoy Ben Shapiro's content unironically and you watch him and you find him to be, like, funny or entertaining, you kind of suck, dude. I'm sorry. Like, you straight up fucking suck. Like, this is the guy you want to be like? It's so far. He's so lame. Like, Dexter's Laboratory, at least Dexter had, like, a personality. You know what I mean? There was redeeming qualities. Like, Ben Shapiro has none.
He's going to drive up this bus over them.
Well, the prince was smoking weed and he was being naked in Vegas. Like, no, you're right, dude. No one should do that.
Back up the bus.
You fucking gigantic dork.
Over them because my wife wants to be a famous actress and wasn't very good in Suits. Now she wants it. So I'm going to go right along. The real villain here is not even Meghan. Right? Meghan is whatever Meghan is. Harry is the one who's the villain. It's his family. Right. So whatever I think of Meghan, I think twice as badly of Harry. Okay. So then Meghan Markle starts talking about how difficult she starts talking about.
I like that maintaining this insane thing such as the monarchy or the royal family, which many people fought and died to never have again, is not the main criticism that Ben Shapiro has. But the main criticism that he has is like the worst thing that the prince has done was speak out against the royal family rather than the existence of the royal family itself. You're defending the royal family right now. Like, you're defending monarchy. You're defending not just like an American monarchy, which I'm sure Ben would love, by the way, let's be real, as long as they're like, you know, homophobic and shit. As a libertarian, you are defending the British monarchy. The level of, like, I mean, this is peasant brain to the max, okay? You cannot have a more peasant-like approach to this situation than to defend the British royalty and the British monarchy. That's what I'm doing here as an American libertarian, by the way. Like, shut the fuck up.
How racist everyone was. And she relates a conversation in which apparently somebody asked how dark her son's skin would be. Now, this would be an excellent time for Oprah, being the interviewer, to ask, okay, can you name a name? I mean, that would be, if someone says something as overtly racist as, how dark is your son's skin going to be? First of all, what kind of stupid, like, I'm just going to say it. I don't believe that happened. I don't think that happened. Honest to God, I don't.
Yeah, I can't believe that that happened. Pretty sure that Oprah already asked that question. Secondly, why can't you believe that happened when it happened in public too? Like, there were members of the literal fucking royal family that were straight up talking about how, like, Meghan Markle being black was a problem. Okay? The entire British newspaper industry, which is incredibly reactionary, shouts out to Rupert Murdoch, you fucking demon, literally would just plaster over and over again comparing Meghan Markle to Kate Middleton. Why the fuck do I know so much about this? This is so whack. But they constantly compared it to Kate Middleton and said, like, you know, she's unkempt. She's not good at, you know, she is not. They kept alluding to the fact that she's black and therefore she's not royalty material.
I don't think it happened. The reason I don't think that happened is because no one says anything like that. That's a ridiculous question. How dark is your son's skin going to be? You're like, beyond, like.
Okay, great. So if it actually happened, then Ben agrees that it's pretty fucking ridiculous. So he's just choosing not to agree. He's choosing to not believe Meghan Markle's sentiment here. Well, there's plenty of evidence that the royal family has been racist outwardly. There's plenty of instances. Hold on, let's find some of these. So we can show it. What was it? I don't like the implication, so I don't think it happened. Well, if anyone thinks the queen is a racist, she's almost as old as Jim Crow. Yeah. The proper argument here is, the proper argument from a Ben Shapiro point of view is to say, well, of course the queen is racist. She's been around for a very long time. She's very old. You know what I mean? Like, that's what you're supposed to say. Like, you're supposed to... You're supposed to fucking say that, you know, obviously she's going to be racist. I mean, some of these people have, like, actual relationships with the German royalty. A lot of these people are of German origin and German descent. There's a lot of inbreeding happening in the royal families in Europe for a very long time. It's a part of their culture. It's a part of what they do. So, of course, there's going to be racism. Obviously, not expecting a 100-year-old person to be racist is ridiculous. You know, it's like your grandpa saying something bad. All Germans are Nazis? No, that's not what I'm saying. But, I mean, brother, come on. In the early to mid-1930s, it wasn't just royalty and prime ministers who believed it was worth appeasing the rising Adolf Hitler. Here are 20 headlines comparing Meghan Markle to Kate Middleton that may show why she and Prince Harry left royal life. Yeah, here. Not long ago, pregnant Kate tenderly cradles her baby bump. Why can't Meghan Markle keep her hands off her bump? Experts tackle the question that has got the nation talking. Is it pride, vanity, acting, or a new age bonding technique? I mean, this is not only fucking super misogynistic and ridiculous to be like, why aren't you fucking, like, expecting to hide your baby bump is so psychotic to begin with. Kate's morning sickness cure? Prince William gifted an avocado for a pregnant duchess. Meghan Markle's beloved avocado linked to human rights abuse, drought, and millennial shame. Kate wins Granny War. Duke and Duchess of Cambridge will spend second private Christmas with the Middleton family rather than joining the Queen in Sandringham. Doesn't the Queen deserve better than this baffling festive absence? Richard Kay examines the impact of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's decision not to spend Christmas with the royal family. Kate and Will's Inc. Duke and Duchess secretly set up companies to protect their brand, just like the Beckhams. A right royal cashin. How Prince Harry and Meghan Markle trademarked over 100 items from hoodies to socks 6 months before split with monarchy, with new empire worth up to $400 million. Stiff upper lip. Prince William blasts monarchy's stiff upper lip tradition to back and backs Harry's admission of his mental anguish after death of Mother Diana. Prince Harry and Meghan ditched British stiff upper lip. Is this a good thing? Son, parents, and kids are torn. So, it's like, this is like, British tabloids are fucking dog shit. They're actually worse than American media, by the way. For those of you who don't know, it is surprising, but British media is so fucking insane. Like, they're absolutely psychopathic. And the royal family shit is an area where they are, like, really, really, really psychopathic. So, yeah, they always, every single thing that they praised Kate Middleton for in the media, they shit on Meghan Markle for. There were also members of the royal family, if I can find it, that there were Queen Nazi salute film, Palace disappointed at use. Their royal highlinesses. This is the media, not the family. No, hold on. The media shit on them, but the family did as well. There were members of the family that would do a bunch of shit. I remember, because I just, like, remember fucking seeing it in the corner of my eye, I guess, when I was processing random-ass information on the internet, and I hate that I fucking know about it. By the way, thank you, Death Gets Us All, for the 5-tier-1 gift subs. There were members of the family that were also being raced towards Meghan Markle. But the hilarity here is to assume that, as I've said before, guys, they are the royal family, okay? They are the British Petroleum of racism. Like, I said this earlier, I gotta repeat myself. The royal family is the Apple iPhone of doing racism. The only reason why they exist or have power is literally because of colonialism, okay? Like, what are you talking about? To be surprised that they were racist when the bloodline was maintained by fucking one another, like inbreeding, to make sure that there was purity, is so insane. Of course they're fucking racist, dude. What are you talking about? Like, they literally fucked their cousins so that they could ensure that, you know, all of this power was kept within pure lineage and pure bloodlines. What the fuck? I I am so confused that people are doing the surprise Pikachu face that the fucking royal family is racist. Yeah, it's called selective breeding. Exactly. Called selective breeding. Half of them were alive when they literally considered half the world their personal property. No shit, they're racist, LMAO. Yeah, like, I don't understand. I don't understand why people would fucking be like shocked. Oh, how dastardly that the royals are racist. What? What do you mean? I cannot believe it, says Ben Shapiro. All right, let's keep going.
The racism of it? The actual stupidity, like the human stupidity of having to ask that question.
Your ancestors were probably racist too? Of course they were, dog. Of course. Yeah. Yeah, my ancestors were fucking racist. And you can probably track down, you can trace down, if you have the capability to do so, you can probably trace down some evil motherfuckers in your lineage. The difference is, I'm not sitting here and, like, defending them right now, okay? If I had grandparents that were doing fucking racist shit, I wouldn't be like, well, you know, we need to defend that.
Do you not know what biracial children look like? Like, that's a, what? Because I don't believe this for a second, but here she is saying a thing I don't, plus she's a, maybe it's true and she's such a bad actress that I can't even tell that it's true. That's possible too. Here is Meghan Markle.
In those months when I was pregnant, all around this same time, so we have in tandem the conversation of, he won't be given security, he's not gonna be given a title. And also, concerns and conversations about how dark his skin might be when he's born.
What? Cut away to Oprah looking all shocked. And of course she connects the fact that Harry, who is like ninth in line for the throne at this point, that Harry is not going to get the security and he's not going to get all this stuff. And again, I believe at this point they'd already decided they wanted to move to America, that was going to be the basis. It was all about skin color. Of course, it was all about the racism. Okay, so she continues along these lines. And then she says that she wanted to commit suicide and the royal family would not get her the mental help that she required. Okay, now, again, I don't know the truth or falsehood of any of these statements. I do know that once you claim that you were suicidal, that you had suicidal ideation, then people generally should not question that. So I will assume that this is true. I also will assume that I have no idea what anybody else did around her because I don't think that she's a credible source about anything other than her own feelings. I think most people are credible sources on their own feelings, but people tend not to be credible sources when their self-interest is at stake. Here's Meghan Markle then trying to impute to the royal family a lack of care for her suicidal ideation, which is a hell of an accusation to make.
Look, I was really ashamed to say it at the time.
Like, you kind of admitted that. Okay, here are some facts, right? So we will never know whether she's honest or not, but we can deduce here, right? Okay, one, Meghan Markle, awful actress, incapable of acting, okay? She couldn't fucking act her way. She could not act to save her life, all right? Come on, we've all watched Suits. So pretty much incapable of lying. Number two, the royal family being racist is perhaps the lightest fucking thing that you could say about the royal family. It's pretty obvious. Of course they're going to be racist. One, because they're 7 million years old. And two, because like they've done a lot of racist shit in the past. And lastly, it's kind of what the royal family is around for. Okay? Racist colonialism is literally the reason why they exist. So it's not all that shocking to assume that she is correct or not lying in this circumstance.
And ashamed to have to admit it to Harry, especially, because I know how much loss he's suffered.
Mm-hmm.
But I knew that if I didn't say it, that I would do it. And I just didn't want to be alive anymore.
Okay, and then what she says is that she went to the institution and they were like, you can't get outside help because if you get outside help, then that is going to become a story in and of itself. Well, okay, first of all, Meghan Markle was a story from like the day that she joined the royal family because she started lecturing everybody inside the palace about race. I mean, she was in the tabloids every single day. So that's number one. Number two, if you think there aren't healthcare workers on staff at the palace, I have doubts. We'll get to more on this in just 1 second. First.
Oh my God, what the fuck is this, dude?
Because again, no names, no specifics. It is all these broad allegations that are being made. And in fact, post-interview, apparently Harry has now come out and says, you know who it wasn't? It wasn't Elizabeth and it wasn't Prince Philip. It wasn't any of the people who people actually care about from the royal family. But they won't name names. Okay, so this was pretty fun. At a certain point, Oprah actually asked Meghan if she left the royal family to brand build. And Meghan is like, no. Of course not. Here she was.
There are even stories that you knew all along that this was going to happen. You went through the whole process and it was all intentional to build your brand.
Can you imagine how little sense that makes? I left my career, my life. I left everything because I love him, right? And our plan was to do this forever. Yeah. Our plan for me, I mean, I wrote letters to his.
Yo, I'm not going to lie. I think Ben just wants to fuck Prince Harry. Like, I think Ben literally just personally is, like, jealous and upset that I can't believe Meghan Markle is being so ridiculous. If I were to be caressed gently in Prince Harry's arms, I would personally be so all right with all manner of different anti-Semitism that I would be subjected to. Do you understand? I mean, I like that. Here's what I think is funny, okay? This is just you being an asshole. Like, this is 14 minutes of Ben just being a fucking inconsiderate, rude douchebag, right? And because of the way that, like, ideological battle lines are drawn, being an inconsiderate fucking douchebag is seen as, like, the conservative position, and it's kind of cool that, like, you know, he's saying things that are really, you know, things that other people are too afraid to say. Like, that's it. Like, that's just it. That's the fucking summarization of conservatism right here. It's just like, yes, this person who says that they wanted to commit suicide or had suicidal ideation is lying. They're lying about the racism. They're lying about everything. Lol. Like, that's it. That's all Ben is doing. He can try to coat it with the intellectual patina of using a Harvard law graduate language. But ultimately, that's all he's doing is just being a fucking asshole, right? Everything that she's saying is a lie. I don't care. Lol. Who cares? She's a liberal. Fuck the libs. Own the libs. Long live the queen. That's all he has done so far.
His family, when I got there, saying, I am dedicated to this. I'm here for you. Use me as you'd like. There was no guidance as well, right? Mm-hmm. There were certain things that you couldn't do, but, you know, unlike what you see in the movies, there's no class on how to speak, how to cross your legs, how to be royal. There's none of that training. That might exist for other members of the family. That was
okay,
not something
okay,
that was offered
okay, 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 okay. The beginning part of that. That's hysterically funny. I'm sorry. That's just from any angle. That is super funny. So Oprah's like, so did you like join the royal family and then you knew that you were going to build your career that way? And she's like, can you imagine? I left my career as a second-rate actress in a third-tier part on Suits to be a princess, and somebody would suggest that I did that for career purposes? No, I did it because I love this dumbass over here. It's because I love the guy sitting next to me. This guy, right here. Prince Harry, Captain Lovable. Love that guy. I mean, I left a job on Suits. On Suits. Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah, I'm sure it was all pure love. Listen, maybe they love each other.
What the fuck, dude? This is kind of gross, dude. Like, this is low-key kind of fucking gross. He's such a nerd. He's like, they don't love each other. They don't. It's got to be projection, right? Like, he just thinks that people are incapable of making decisions like this because they like one another. Again, there is a more appropriate way of arguing this position. You could literally say something along the lines of, like, well, him being a fucking prince probably factors into his development and the kind of person that he is. So obviously, like, it's hard to see, like, Prince Harry as something that is not a prince. So of course the fucking Duke and Duchess titles factor into it or something. But like the way he's talking about it is so sad. I don't understand it at all. I find it very weird. Like, there was no love there. It was a loveless marriage. It's all because he's a prince. Okay, shut up. Shut up. I know it.
That's fine. Sure. All right. Sure. I'm sure career had nothing to do with it. I'm sorry. I left my job on Suits, and you're suggesting that maybe becoming a princess was a career move? A little. A little, I'm suggesting. Because that is not a horizontal move right there. I'm sorry. When you think of like horizontal versus vertical career moves.
Bro, he is such an incel, dude. You called his love for Harry is undeniable. Yeah, no, he is. He, like, I think he literally loves Prince Harry. Like, he wants to be Princess Shabibo real bad. Like, it honestly, unironically sounds like he's jealous. Like, why can't I do that? Why can't I marry a royal and get an upwards career move? Wait, your joke about Ben wanting to be caressed by Harry is a homophobic joke and a trope. You must know this. Yes, I am. Well, it's because I'm a homophobic person. I think that's why. And that's why I was making a homophobic joke, because I was doing a ha ha, it's funny because he's having gay sex type joke, and not because I'm saying that he legitimately is he legitimately seems fucking bent out of shape, because like deep in his mind somewhere he would love to be in that position. The hilarity comes from his jealousy, not that ha ha, gay people aren't funny. BC police, wee-woo, exactly. I love that. You guys got me. I was hiding it this entire time. Ben is literally the guy that thinks race and sex jokes are funny, and the rest of the group looks at him like he's messed up.
Actress on Suits.
It was a bad joke. Just move on. Ugh. I get so... some of you guys are so fucking annoying, dude. You're doing that thing again.
To all princess. Right. Is that a horizontal move? I'm going to go no on that one. No. Okay, but again, Markle is not the actual villain of this piece. Meghan Markle is whatever Meghan Markle is. Okay, Prince Harry is the villain of the piece. He knows all the members of his family. He's the one who has decided that he is going to go along with whatever his wife wants to do here. And he's going to say terrible, terrible things about his family. And he's going to prove that he is morally superior to his family. So, for example, Prince Harry, he says that he is free. His brother and his father, they are trapped, but he is so free now. He's free like a bird, and he is free to speak about the evils of his own family. First of all, people who dump on their own families typically ask jackasses, like not good people. Here's Prince Harry. You know, but I'm free. They're trapped. I'm here with you, Oprah, with you. Here's Prince Harry, who, again, worse than Meghan Markle.
Please explain how you, Prince Harry, raised in a palace, in a life of privilege, literally a prince, how you were trapped.
Just move on. Gets under my skin, man. I get you. Oh, dude, yeah, it's the most annoying. Like, you lost. Hold this L. It is the woke scoldy version of just saying, hold this L, you fucking bitch. That's what it is. When people say, no, you were wrong, move on. Can you just move on, please? Like, no, I'm not gonna fucking move on. I'm gonna stay right on the subject.
Trapped within the system. Like the rest of my family are. My father and my brother, they are trapped. They don't get to leave. And I have huge compassion for that.
Wow. I mean, they don't get to leave. They're trapped. But I am free here with you, Oprah. And you know, I got cut off from the royal fortune. I could only live on my mother's $25 million endowment. That's really what they said. $25 million. Okay, so there's an actual deeper underlying thing that's going on here, and that has to do with racism and colonialism. There's been this move in Britain to do sort of what you've seen in the United States, which is the entire history of Britain is about colonialism and racism and brutality, in the same way that the entire history of America is about racism and colonialism and brutality.
Dude, come on, dude. Are you fucking insane? You're really saying that the history of the royal family is not about racism and colonialism and brutality? Like at least with America, you could straight up say, and a lot of conservatives used to say this, that America escaped that, okay? That America was supposed to be a penal colony and they fought back and, you know, fuck the royalty, fuck the monarchy. That's why America is the land of freedom. That's what conservatives are supposed to say and do say from time to time. But like, defending America's white supremacy is the expectation that I have from conservatives. But then to take it one step further and be a fucking loyalist to the British crown in the United States of America is not what I would have expected conservatives to do.
Brutality, right? This is all tied in. And Prince Harry backs that to the hilt. So he starts talking about how...
Like, at this point, it's like nothing is racist. Slavery is not racist. I don't know why people are saying slavery is racist. Hypothetically, why would slavery be racist? Everyone did slavery. Like, that's the final point of this argument. Okay? That is the final point of this argument. It's like, if you don't think America has white supremacist underpinnings in its establishment, or that's one thing, which is still bad, okay, and false and ahistorical. But to say that the royal family does not have white supremacy and colonialism in its roots is insane, dude. What the fuck are they there for then? Like, where? This is the whole point of the royal family. You're supposed to be anti-royal family, Ben. You are a libertarian, supposedly. An American libertarian. What the fuck?
How? He's done the work, right? Other members of the royal family, they didn't do the work. He says racism drove him out of Britain. It was the tabloids and their racism that drove him out of Britain. And then he says, quote, I've spent many years doing the work and doing my own learning, but then my upbringing and the system in which I was brought up and in which I've been exposed to, I wasn't aware of it to start with, but by God, it doesn't take very long to suddenly become aware of it. It takes living in her shoes for a day or those first 8 days to see where it was going to go and how far they were going to take it and get away with it. Yes, yes. Now he's going to lecture the royal family on their race. Again, the only reason he's a relevant figure is because this is a relevant institution, but this is an attempt to tear down the institution. So let's be clear about what this is. Okay, at least by Prince Harry. And, you know, I think that Markle is just bringing American brand racial politics to Britain. And it's kind of an ugly sight. It is kind of, especially if you're not willing to name names, because let's be real about this. If somebody said that as an employee of the royal family and she named the name, they'd be fired. Right now, there's an investigation going on into Meghan Markle, right? Not into the royal family. It's going on into Meghan Markle and how she treated the employees and the staff over there.
What?
The reason this has some deeper significance, though, truly, is because what everybody recognizes is that the British monarchy being essentially just a facade at this point, that it really doesn't have any institutional power. All it is just a face for the history of Britain. And when Harry and Meghan make the case that the British monarchy is rife with colonialism and racism, that they have not moved beyond any of that, that there is still...
The alternative is if the royal family... Okay, I'm going to tell you something right now. Here's the God's honest truth, okay? The alternative is if the royal family had embraced Meghan Markle across the board and was, like, celebrating her and saying, like, we need more black queens or whatever the fuck, right? Ben would literally be ripping in to the monarchy... aggressively. Like, this is liberalism. I mean, I thought liberals were against the monarchy. All of a sudden, they're for the monarchy now that there's a black female monarch. Like, you know that. You know that for a fucking fact. And that's because he holds zero positions. The only position that he maintains is owning the fucking libs, and whatever he has decided is liberal. That's it. You're a black person, probably a liberal. You are, you're... There's no way that you can engage in cancel culture against them, and they're always doing cancel culture. Huge assumption. Okay. Sure. Well, you're right. It is an assumption, and I think it's correct. Shapiro will criticize Harry for going against his family, but also criticize for not outing the person. The decades of colonialism has plagued so many South Asian countries, even to this day. The world would be so much different if these people didn't exist. Yeah.
Still this deep systemic racism that is inherent in the most beloved part of the British government, namely the figurehead. What they're really saying is that all of British history and really British society is infused with the same sort of systemic racism they accuse America of having as well. That's what this is all about. I hope you enjoyed that clip from the Ben Shapiro.
Was there like a black monarch in Bridgerton? Maybe we can like actually put this to a test. Was there someone was talking about Bridgerton and shit. Like, was there like actually a black monarch or something? And well, what the fuck's going on? Twitch is down again.